The reason that the Institute is so crucial at this time is that we face unprecedented challenges. Melbourne, for instance, is a city that's going to double in size by 2050. We've got increasing awareness of the negative effects of climate change. We've got mass migration. We're worrying about our security for food and water and energy. We have to think about the mobility challenges, and we've also got health challenges of aging populations. We have four key programs that the Institute will be focusing on. They are new urban government structures, sustainable urban mobility, smart spaces for home and work, and smart and sustainable infrastructure and delivery systems.
As a university of technology, clearly we have our eye on developing technologies that have the potential to disrupt and transform our cities and create an agenda that's very much supportive of our citizens. So the Smart Cities Research Institute at Swinburne will be unique because it places our citizens at the heart of the strategy. And this is the agenda of all of our five institutes, whereby they are really the five pillars of one institute, which is Swinburne.
There are reasons why I think the Swinburne Research Institute has the potential to get ahead of the game. And that is principally because of the fact that we're launching it alongside the other four research institutes. And so there's a great opportunity to integrate the research across related areas.
It's really important for Smart Cities Research to be led out of Melbourne today because we have this incredible asset of students, researchers, academics in our city who are citizens themselves and can connect to the challenges we need to solve for Melbourne, whether it be related to safety or congestion or environmental challenges, and to apply the knowledge, the skills, the capabilities we have to create the solutions of the future and to inform IP patents and to inform new businesses that might be starting up on the back of this work.
So smart cities are those which understand the importance of behavioural change as a key lever to a different outcome. And that's because at the end of the day, cities are all about people. They're all about the experience that you feel in the city.
Our institute will focus on defining the smart citizen to help create and run the smart city. In short, we will be playing our part in assuring that Australia, home to some of the world's most livable cities, will be recognised for being home to the world's most smartest smart cities.